Let's talk a little bit about dew point alarms. You know, a thermal imaging camera is not to be used to identify or conclude what a particular issue is. The terminology that I like to use is the camera showing me an area of investigation. And that's what this is up here. This is an area of investigation. Is it moisture or is it missing insulation? What is it? The camera doesn't tell me that. So I would take a moisture meter over to this point and then check it out. And that's what I'd use to verify whether that's moisture or not. But let's use this as an example of finding condensation, because condensation is it's related to a temperature. And so you can use the camera basically to identify condensation issues because it's related to dew point. Now this is to be understood in context that your camera, remember, is plus or minus 2, usually plus or minus 2 degrees accurate in the original calibration at the factory, plus your thermal hygrometer, which gives you the dew point. Is it accurate? That's the question. So given that, let's say the thermal hygrometer tells me that the dew point is 60 degrees, and let's say my camera is accurate. That being the case, on the software, I'm going to take my color alarm and enable it. And I'm going to choose the alarm below threshold. That would mean that wherever I put my threshold, and I'm going to put it at the dew point. Dew point we said is 60. So let's go up to 60, and that means that everything that I'm looking at here would be condensation, because it's a temperature-related phenomena, given that my temperatures are accurate. Okay. Now, another way to do this out in the field is, let's turn off the color alarm, disable it. So let's say we're out in the field with camera in hand. How can I set my camera up to find condensation? I would recommend you go to the grayscale, and then the bottom of your span bar, run it up to your dew point. We said the dew point is 60. Let's go up to 60. Let me run that down. Just there we go. Now you see how obvious it is as to what areas are at or below 60 degrees, and that would mean then that we have condensation, these issues. So whether you're using this method with your camera in hand or using the color alarm method on the software, we can identify these particular issues.